Remember all those vaccines you got as a child? Or perhaps more recently, you went to your local pharmacy for the seasonal flu vaccine? Now, what if I told you that something as simple as the water you drink every day could cause those vaccines to become ineffective? That sounds pretty scary, right? This is an unfortunate reality for hundreds of millions of people around the world. And there's growing evidence that this may even be an issue here in parts of the United States. One of the culprits for this? A common drinking water contaminant called arsenic. Globally, 1 in 50 people is exposed to unsafe levels of arsenic in their drinking water, with many millions of them residing right here in the US. The majority of them, however, are exposed through contaminated groundwater and private wells, though. So never fear, Baltimore's municipal water supply is clear. Now, you may be asking yourself at this point, like, why don't we just take the arsenic out of the water, right? Like, wouldn't that solve the problem? While this is technologically feasible, it is financially prohibitive. So there's another way that we can address this problem, and that's by improving upon the vaccines that we already have. That's where my research comes in. Because if you want to improve upon what you already have, you have to first understand how arsenic is affecting the immune response to those vaccines. In order to study this, I've designed an animal model where I utilize mice as a sort of human surrogate, exposing them to low, environmentally relevant doses of arsenic through their drinking water in much the same way that humans are exposed. I then vaccinate them against flu, or really any other vaccine would work here, but flu's what I use. And then I measure the success of the immune response to the vaccine. This success is measured through a variety of immune parameters, but the most important of which are these special proteins called antibodies. When you're vaccinated against flu, your immune system responds by building these antibodies that remember the virus, and their sole job is to fight it off should you ever come into contact with it again. The preliminary results of my research suggest that exposure to arsenic reduces circulating levels of these special antibodies, thus diminishing our body's number one defense against this virus. In my remaining 2 years here as a graduate student, I hope to further elucidate the precise mechanisms governing this effect that arsenic has on our immune response to vaccination, with the idea that this information could help us build better vaccines that will work in even the most environmentally challenging conditions globally. Because if we are truly committed to continuing to save lives through vaccination, we must ensure that these tears are never shed in vain, no matter what water you have to drink. Thank you.